G'day there, guys. He's behind me again, isn't he? He's just staring. Menacingly. It's your main man, Marky, and welcome back to another episode of Being Stalked by Kanye. Today I'll be reading some r/AmITheAhole stories, so I hope you enjoy them, and I hope that you sleep well tonight. Thank you. Posted by user, I am a dad of two girls. Titled, Am I the A-hole for trying to get my girls interested in my hobbies and interests instead of getting into theirs? So I have two girls, 13 and 10, with my wife of 9 years. My girls are typical girls and don't have a lot of interests in common with me. I tried from a young age to get them interested in things that we could share. They just never got interested. I'm talking things like video games, science fiction, and fantasy books, Star Wars, Iron Man, Batman, etc. These are all popular things that I see a lot of other parents getting into with their kids. They are more interested in things I just can't relate to. The 13-year-old is into fashion, clothes, makeup, hair, all of that. The younger one really likes animals and Jojo Bo. I've tried to be interested in their things. We watched this really bad, campy TV show called One Day at a Time, but I didn't like it and found the writing bad, and they got mad at me when I would laugh. The older ones liked the show Riverdale, which I admit was a little more interesting, but it was all a bunch of gossipy teen stuff. I just hit a wall. I couldn't figure out why I was going through all of this effort to spend time with them when they obviously don't care enough to be interested in things I care about either. I tried to sit down with them and watch The Mandalorian, and they didn't like it. That really hurt me. Like, really, really hurt me. I know kids aren't going to be your own reflection staring back at you, but I thought I'd at least be able to share the things I love with them. I thought we'd get to spend time together, instead of being one of those fractured families with no interest in each other. I told my wife that I was sick of feeling like an outsider in my own family, and that I'd like it if we could maybe do some designated time that we would do things I liked too. I suggested we could all sit down and learn to play this board game I like, Settlers of Catan. My wife told me that I need to stop trying to force my stuff down their throats and find a balance somehow. I told her that this is the balance. I can't pretend to be interested in things like gossipy TV dramas, soap operas, etc., when that just isn't me. I'm not a teenage girl, I can't pretend to be one. Am I the a-hole? I feel lonely in my own family. While it's unfortunate they don't like the stuff that you're into, it's kind of not their job as your kids to be into those things if they don't want to, neither is anyone else. Yes, it's unfortunate they don't like it, and yes, it's unfortunate you don't like their stuff, but that doesn't mean you force your stuff until they do like it. That doesn't sound like a good compromise, and that doesn't sound like a good idea. They are not forcing you to participate in their activities. They like spending time with you. You're their dad, they're your kids. You should find common ground and put up with things that they like that you don't particularly like, because you need to form a connection with them. And also, they're not getting angry at you, and they're not forcing you to do things that they like that you don't. That definition alone doesn't make them the a-hole, but it certainly makes you one. So that's what I'm going with. You're the a-hole. In the comments, RevMat says, You're the a-hole. Part of being a parent is taking an interest in what your kids are into, whether you like it or not. And trying to force kids to get into whatever you're interested in pretty much never works. Yep. What's the bet Mom has done most of the parenting, and he thought she just really enjoyed Peppa Pig and In the Night Garden? You're the a-hole, OP. Learn to enjoy spending time with your own kids. What? You mean mums don't read The Very Hungry Caterpillar a million times because it's their favourite piece of English literature? Do you know how many books I've memorised from sheer repetition? At least the better ones have a good rhythm. Shout out to Dr. Seuss. You're the a-hole. They are literal kids. It's not their job to placate you to build a relationship. These are the years that you connect and show interest in them, not complain that their perfectly normal and appropriate young girl interests aren't exciting enough for you. Why should they be interested in you when you're not interested in them? This is so typical of men. Things young girls are into are considered boring and lame, but this guy's an adult and still reading Batman comics, and that's fine? Nothing wrong with reading comics, that is to say, but the fact that comics which are written for kids and teens are totally valid, while his young girl's interests aren't, tells me a lot about how he sees women and their interests. Yep, it's pretty telling that his attempts at bridging the gap are so stereotypical male things. He didn't even try to find a middle ground. Biking, hiking, swimming, baseball, soccer, rock climbing, art, cooking, camping, skiing, basketball, Harry Potter, ooh, Hermione. Nope, didn't extend himself at all. Just, well, they need to like what I like, or I will laugh at them right in their faces. You feel like an outsider because your kids don't want to read Batman comics? Oh boy. You're the a-hole. You're the parent, suck it up and spend time with your kids. There's nothing wrong with having a game night, but you can't force your kids into your hobbies. You sound like a whiny brat right now. Listen to your wife. Posted by user SuperPizza2985. Titled, Am I the A-hole for not wanting to leave my own apartment? I'll keep this vague to avoid recognition, since I believe the parts involved actually use Reddit. I'm a 28-year-old male, and I've been friends with my roommate, a 25-year-old female, ever since we were babies. Our families were neighbors, and we grew up together. She's like a little sister to me, and always has been. After she graduated college, she moved to the same city I currently work in, and since she couldn't find an apartment close enough to where she worked, I told her she could live with me. We'd share bills and become roommates. We never really had problems or fights as we've known each other for so long. However, recently, things have taken a strange turn. She got involved with someone from her work. The guy seemed to be a nice guy. I've only ever spoken to him 3 times, as they usually keep to her room. But he was very friendly, and honestly, I was happy she found someone who seemed that nice. After a few months of their relationship, she sent me a text saying she needed to talk with me. I figured there might be something wrong with the apartment. It's not uncommon for things to break. But I was wrong. When I got home, we started talking. It's too long to write everything, so I'll just summarize. She told me that while she enjoyed living with me, her boyfriend was starting to get jealous of his woman living with another man. At first I raised an eyebrow, but I thought that this kind of thing isn't uncommon. So I was like, oh, it's fine, just let me know when you plan on leaving. Hope you two find a good place. However, apparently I was wrong. She told me that she wasn't leaving. She said that it was impossible to find someone closer to her work, and that she was hoping I would let her take the apartment instead, since my work wasn't close and all that. Thing is, I really love my place. It's close to the gym, to the grocery store, to pretty much everything. I'm not just gonna leave my place because of something so stupid as this, and I told her flat out that it wasn't going to happen. She got visibly upset and started to rant about me being an egotistical asshole, that I didn't have empathy to put myself in her shoes. This happened a few days ago, and she's shut herself in her room, only ever leaving to go to work or pick up her boyfriend, who became really unfriendly to me after that. Now, usually I can be an a-hole, but I don't think this is one of these times, so I thought I would ask for Reddit's verdict. Am I really such an a-hole? Edit, I didn't expect this to get this much attention. For those who have asked, her name isn't on the lease, as I lived in the same place for 2 years before she moved in. OP has offered the following explanation for why they think they might be the a-hole. My childhood friend wants me to leave my apartment for her, since her boyfriend is jealous of us living together. While this might sound silly, I am usually an a-hole, but I don't think I am in this case. However, we've been at this for days, and it's making me feel really bad about it, which might make me an a-hole at the end of the day. And I might be an a-hole for saying this one as well, but this sounds like a them problem. Damn, that really sucks for you, Chief. God, it sucks to be this couple that has created a them problem. Sounds like their problem to me. In what universe is this okay for her to ask you to move out when you've been there for 2 years? This is your lifestyle. Nothing is changing. She shouldn't expect you to change. Sure, she may be your childhood friend, but that gives her no more excuse or reason to force you out of this place. Childish act on her behalf. She is acting like an absolute child, and so is this boyfriend for being jealous. Disgustingly childish behavior by these two. She's 25 years old. She should know better than this by now. If she wants to placate her little jealous boyfriend who throws a temper tantrum when he doesn't get his way, they can go live somewhere happily ever after together that isn't this apartment. It's obvious to me that they can't take no for an answer, that they can't get over the fact that a man and a woman can live together without anything happening, especially being childhood friends. And if they're gonna throw a hissy fit over this and, you know, take this out on OP, not talk to OP, that's absolutely their prerogative, but I judge them for being absolute babies. So no, OP, stand your ground, don't listen to them, deal with this like an adult does, because you're definitely not going to get adult behavior from these two. Not the a-hole. Now in the comments, MeatCube says, "Let me get this straight. You have known her for over 2 decades. You welcome her into your own home, and now she expects you to leave so she can live with her jealous boyfriend that she's just gotten on with? Not the a-hole, bro. She is, big time. Look at how she treats someone who is like a sibling. I'm super curious as to why she's not going over to her boyfriend's place. Why doesn't the friend and her boyfriend find a place of their own rather than try to kick someone out who was nice enough to let her move another place? Theory. She told boyfriend it was her place and she was being a great friend letting OP crash there. Now she's been caught out in the lie. This is kind of what I was starting to feel," she told her boyfriend. She should have realized that she would have had to tell the boyfriend the truth eventually if she told him that lie. Oh my god, not the a-hole. She can pack her entitlement up with her crap and move out. It's your apartment. You did her the favor. The effing audacity, I swear. Don't be surprised when she reappears on your doorstep, wanting to move back in when living with the boyfriend doesn't work out. She sounds less than mature. Just say no, not the a-hole. It probably won't work out because her boyfriend is an insecure, controlling a-hole. St. Alvis says, not the a-hole. That's some A5 Wagyu level entitlement right there. She said that it was impossible to find someone closer to her work, and that she was hoping I would let her take the apartment instead, since my work wasn't close and all of that. Wait, so she's not even moving in with the boyfriend. She just wants you gone. I think he meant somewhere, and autocorrect played a trick on him. And Academic Nobody 4964 says, not the a-hole. It was your place first, and she's the one having an issue with the living situation. If her new boyfriend has such a problem with her living with you, then he should offer her to move in with him. What she ends up doing is totally her choice, but you shouldn't be forced to move, and I think she's being incredibly unreasonable. Actually, it wasn't his place first. It was his place always, and her place never. This, she isn't even on the lease, not the a-hole. Posted by user Mama2456, titled, Am I the a-hole for letting my daughter use my son's car when he was away at college and not telling him when she damaged it? This has caused a lot of stir in our household, and I'm finally deciding to post on this sub. Longtime reader. My son is 20 and a sophomore in college. He currently lives there in an apartment, but does not have his car there. He has left his car at home, but is adamant that nobody use it. In October, my daughter turned 16. She went and got her driver's license a few weeks after. She passed the test with no problems, though I'll admit she struggled at times when she drove with me. Her best friend lives in the same subdivision as us, a 4-minute drive half a mile away. There's no traffic or stoplights involved when driving to her friend's house. Well, she really wanted to drive herself there the day she got her license, I had some errands to run, so I let her take my son's car. And, well, I watched her pull out of our driveway and completely clip the side of the car against our brick mailbox. The right front headlight was smashed, and the bumper had a pretty big dent and scrapes. My son has a pretty bad temper, and I was terrified about how he'd react. Daughter is very quiet and sensitive, and I know my son would probably dish out enough insults to her to put her in therapy. Not knowing what to do, I called my mom to see if she'd pay to get it fixed. She was the one who bought him the car. After she told me she would, I kind of forgot about it. Son came home from school a week before I expected him to, and the car wasn't sent to be repaired yet. I don't want to get into the reaction too much, but he was not very happy. He was furious at both me and his sister. He tore into her really bad, making her cry. I recently was finally able to put a stop to him calling her an invalid. This has been a problem for years, since daughter showed signs of social awkwardness, but I finally got him to stop as of last year. But after this, he kept sarcastically gloating that he was right and his sister is an R-word. He said he was taking all of his valuables out of our home because he obviously can't trust me with anything of his. My mum paid for the car to be fixed, but son is insisting his sister or I pay my mum back for the damages since it was our fault and we're getting off without consequences. I know I was wrong to lend him the car, but I tried to hide it from him only to protect my daughter. Was I wrong? And edit, daughter is not in therapy for the way her brother treats her. I had a poor choice of words. I did not mean that literally. I just meant that he can be a bit of a name caller if he's really angry about something. OP has offered the following explanation for why they think they may be the a-hole. I let my daughter use my son's car without permission, and she damaged it. I hid it from my son to protect daughter from his outburst. I think a lot of the failure is on your part here, OP, for not stopping a lot of these things from the get-go. Obviously, these are two people who can make their own decisions and do their own things, but that name-calling should have been destroyed at the source. He's 20 years old and a sophomore in college, using that language on your daughter. That is absolutely disgusting on his part. I can understand why he'd be mad that his car was destroyed in a way like that, but there is no way that you can come back from calling someone the R-word. That's just not acceptable in our society and isn't compatible with what everyone else says. Now, I'm not blaming OP for him saying these words. I'm saying it looks like a lot of things could have been prevented by OP and, you know, teaching the daughter to drive properly or the daughter paying attention while she's driving and not destroying a car would have done wonders here. I think major fault here is on OP for allowing the daughter to drive the car when, you know, the son expressly said, "Do not drive my car. No one's allowed to drive my car." And then, of course, you keep coming back to the point that you didn't tell him about it and you tried to get it fixed and you didn't get it fixed. And then he's pissed off because you hid that from him. That really sucks. I'm going to go with everyone sucks here. This is a mess. Now in the comments, Eden Gone Dark says, "Everyone sucks here, but you suck the most." There's a lot to unpack here. 1. You gave your daughter permission to use her brother's car without his permission when he explicitly told you not to. This makes you an a-hole. 2. You didn't tell your son it was damaged immediately after the fact. This makes you an a-hole. 3. You asked your mother to fix it for you instead of owning up to your own F-up and fixing it yourself. This makes you triple the a-hole and irresponsible. 4. You say you finally got your son to stop calling your daughter an invalid after years of it? Excuse me, why the F would you let that go on for years? And 5. Your son is an a-hole for calling his sister the R-word. I'm even having a hard time considering your daughter an a-hole at all, seeing as you gave her permission. And then you sit there and let your son verbally abuse her as a result of your mistake? Step up. Parent your kids. Quote, "My son has a bad temper," end quote. I wonder if he just has a bad temper, or if there's more to it than that. My dad required keys to our vehicles when we lived at home, yet you never had to say, don't let anyone drive it. So if OP is willing to ignore that to the extent of putting a new driver behind the wheel, then I'm curious if there's a bunch of other times OP has done stuff like that to their son. I suspect the son's temper is a result of a sister who has repeatedly intruded on his personal space and damaged his possessions while being too quiet and sensitive to ever be punished. Or does he have a temper because mum is a boundary stomper and sister is a convenient target because she's quiet and sensitive? We only know about the car borrowing. However, if she saw no problem with allowing sister to borrow brother's car, I wonder what else she might have done that could constitute a massive boundary stomp. You're the a-hole. If it's in his name, he could sue you or his sister for theft and damage. Pay back, apologize, admit you effed up. You're the a-hole. I'm not entirely sure why you wouldn't be. I get protecting your daughter from what he says, but if you're that worried about his temper, why let your 16-year-old daughter, who's a new driver that sometimes struggles, drive his car? No forethought in this. You're the a-hole. 1. This was not yours to learn. 2. Your daughter had trouble driving with you, and not even a day later, but just hours after you loan her a car that wasn't yours to loan. 3. She couldn't even drive out of the driveway, and you couldn't pay for the repairs. 4. You hid the damage from him. And 5. You obviously should pay your mother back. You were more worried about protecting your daughter than there being consequences for her damaging the car. You were in the wrong on all accounts. G'day there, guys, and that's the end of today's episode. I do hope you enjoyed it and were entertained by today's bloody good content. As always, I want to do a quick shout out and a thank you to all my channel members and Patreon subscribers. Your beautiful faces and names will be up on screen right now. Haven't forgot about you guys. Sorry, I was taking a little break there. So yeah, if you see yourself, give yourself a pat on the back. If you want to be on this screen, there's links down to the description below where you can sign up and help support the channel and all future projects that I'm going to be doing on this one. With all that said, I hope you guys have an amazing day, night, sleep, whatever you're up to. I'll see you in the next episode, and I do hope you enjoy it. Thank you.